Hello, today for review I've got really expensive and really unique IEMs made by a company which is also named Unique Melody. It is their flagship model Mason version 3. It's upgraded version of their flagship that they are developing for many years, but actually they have longer history. Unique Melody was one of the pioneers in the custom IEM world, and they are pretty well known in the audiophilia community. Of course, they are not standing still on their place, resting with their existing lineup. They are always trying to find something unusual and offers something really interesting, some really interesting options to their customers. This model is the result of their long research. They've ended up with this model. Its price is $2,700, both in custom and universal version. Of course, it's huge, absolutely big, enormous amount of money, but it's a price that you have to pay to get one of the best IEMs ever. I'm often asked, are there any IEMs that can be compared with good full-size headphones? And now I can definitely answer yes, there are such IEMs, but they are indeed really expensive. So let's take a closer look at these IEMs. Outer box is relatively simple. It's a black cardboard box with pleasant texture and just a company logo printed here. So when you open it, first thing that you will see, it's a plug case for storing IEMs themselves and a card with serial number. Actually, it's also a USB flash with additional information about these IEMs. And underneath you will have an accessory set. Usually with universal, unfortunately I have to go for universal version because I can't make an impressions when in place where I live now. So with universal version you will have silicone tips, but I didn't got them, but I've got I've got three pair of good comply foams, but I've got tons of tips, so it's not an issue. Cleaning clothes and a nice magnetic strip for cable winding. There are a lot of such things, but this one is magnetic, so it's easy to use. And inside of this box you will have IEMs themselves. Here they are. So accessory set is pretty good. You will have everything that you will need, almost everything, but of course few packages of dehumidifier with silica gel could benefit in this accessory set, and also probably some cleaning tool would be nice too. If you are going to buy this model maybe in some future, be prepared to spend hours and hours in a constructor on the Unique Melody site. They have a huge, absolutely probably the biggest amount of options that I've ever seen in the custom IEMs world. Different faceplate designs, wood, carbon, metal, color printing and so on and so forth. Different shell colors, color swirls, combinations, glitter, some ultraviolet options. Also, they have a really stylish new design that they've called Dreamweaver. It's multi-layered with special fibers inside. It also looks really stylish. They also have a magic color option when customs or universal IEMs will change shell color depending on the temperature. Depending on the outside temperature, so you will have to spend really lot of time configuring them and finding proper design. I've decided to make a shortcut here, so I've opted in for special limited edition versions that Unique Melody created for this year, and Pantone called this year called color of this year ultraviolet. So this design is called ultraviolet. So as you can see, really unusual combination of violet color with nice swirls looking pretty stylish. Sometimes I prefer transparent design, but in this case I think it's one of the best options I've ever seen. So just company logo, because such great artwork should bear creator's logo on them. When you see them, it's hard to believe that Unique Melody indeed managed to use 16 drivers in this tiny shell. So 16 drivers and sophisticated 4-way crossover. 4 drivers for low frequencies, 4 drivers for lower mids, 4 drivers for upper mids, and 4 drivers for treble, if I remember right. So in a custom version they have 5 bores in spout, but in universal version everything is covered with this protective grill, so I'm not sure how many bores are here, but I think there will be 5 also. So each group of drivers have separate bore, and 5th one is for this proprietary low frequencies tuning system. I will cover this system a bit later. Using this knob you can select amount of sub bass that is present here. Suppose I've learned how to pronounce the word bass now. So what else I could say? Building these IEMs, Unique Melody uses new ultra precision 3D printer, so they can get inner part of this really repeat with good repeat. So how to say it in another way. So inner designs are the same in the custom and universal version because they are 3D printed, and outer shells are made by hand, so they all have a unique design and finish. So it's nice to have a same level of repeat in between different models. So also these cases are really reliable and really sturdy. Of course they are very ergonomic, they fit into ears really nicely because the design of the shape is done absolutely perfect with all the experience that Unique Melody gathered for years of work. There is absolutely zero issues with fit, perfect angle of spouts, they are pretty long, as you can see, nice. They are not too short and they are not too wide here, so they fit into ears really pretty deeply, providing both good comfort and nice sound isolation. Actually, these silicone tips are from some other IEMs. I've selected something from my big box of tips. And yet another unique and interesting feature, it's a dual tone cable. There are a lot of discussions all over the internet which material of the cable is better. Copper, aluminium, sorry, not aluminium, of course, it's audiophilic IEMs, of course, no aluminium. Copper, silver plated copper, gold, and so on. With this IEMs you will have a dual tone cable. You can select between silver and copper. It's not a hybrid model because there are two different pairs of cables braided in one. So you can switch between copper version and silver version. They are using unusual connectors with a screw. So to switch them you have to unscrew this connector, unscrewed, disconnected, and swap left and right versions. So this is the way of switching between the copper and silver version. They indeed offers a bit different sound, and together with these low tuning options, they actually allows you politely alter the sound signature. I'm highlighting word politely here because they have their own unique sound signature, and you can alter it, but just a little bit, actually not too much tuning, just small nuances and hints. So to summarize this part, build quality is outstanding, comfort is really great, lot of interesting design and options, and lot of really interesting features. So everything that you can expect from the top tier IEMs. Speaking about the sound, first thing that you will have to notice is that they are really tip dependent. So if it's possible for you, I really recommend you to go for the custom version. It's a really expensive model, so I suggest you to make it a really endgame option. When it's tailored by your ear's impressions, it's a unique thing that will suit only for you and provide absolutely best sound isolation, best fit, best comfort, and so on. But if you go for the universal version, then you have to spend some time finding proper tips. I prefer these tips. If I remember right, it's Visonic tips with it's silicone tips with some foam inside. So proper fit is necessary. And the sound, as I've said before, is tunable, and first thing that you can tune it using this rotating thing, you can select additional amount of sub bass. Actually, amount of adding isn't big. In theory, you can select some medium value here, for example, like that, but usually it's simplest and best way is to turn this knob all the way down or all the way up. So in this case you will add or remove additional 4 decibel boost on the sub bass on the lowest low frequencies. And actually I'm not sure here which one of two options I prefer, because with some styles I like this additional boost, with other genre I don't, maybe don't know how to say it, I prefer it without this boost. And on pretty big amount of recordings actually there is no big difference, because not everywhere this lowest layers of sound and of music is noticeable. So it depends on your genre, what you will prefer. So lows here go really deep, they have a great texturing, good speed, perfect amount of attacks and decays. They are not overemphasized here like in some other IEMs. They are not moved forward, they just stay on their place, and they only do their work of building great foundation. Of course, they have enough dynamics and enough punch to represent all necessary things like rumble, some hard strikes, and so on and so forth. They are good with almost any genre, and with electronic music, with pop music, they have good amount of sub bass to give your brain necessary massage, don't know correct pronunciation of this word, but I hope you understand. So, but on the music with properly recorded acoustic instruments, they lows stay on their perfect place. They are not absolutely not bleeding on the mids, so they just doing their job. When necessary, they can be polite and gentle. When necessary, they can move forward and strike. Mid frequencies depends on the selected cable, and probably it's most noticeable difference between these two cables. Copper one adds a bit hint of warmth, especially on the lower mids, and silver one makes them more linear and less warm, less natural for those who prefer natural and monitoring signature. Mids are resolving, but actually they're not going into this super thin, super resolving sound of typical balanced armatures with one or two drivers. There are here used 8 drivers for mid frequencies, and they definitely do their job really well. Unique melody built really coherent crossover, so there is no noticeable edges on the between the different drivers frequency ranges, so no this noticeable drop-offs. Vocal is moved a bit forward here, especially with copper cable. Actually, copper cable adds a bit of warmth and a bit of intimacy. So vocal with them moved forward, and it's really superb with some jazz recordings, with some classical music. With silver it's not as forward as with copper. It's more of, depend on the recording itself. So it silver offers more, how to say it, more honest, more natural build of imaginary stage. So speaking about staging, they are really close to some full-size headphones, and it's really great for the IEMs. Stage is wide, deep, with perfect layering, with perfect three-dimensional positioning of the instruments, so everything is on their places, and everything has all instruments, vocals have their necessary size, so they are just positioned perfectly and you can really immerse into the sound. So mids have really good resolution, so absolutely zero issues here. They are not sound clinical, so everything is balanced here. You can select, you need more warmth or more natural presentation, whatever you like. Actually, I usually prefer added lower frequencies and silver cable because I like more natural sound. And on the styles like heavy metal or hard rock, which I listen sometimes, they offer a bit more aggression and it's a necessary boost in their general presentation, which gives you the sense of aggression and all the distorted guitars and other instruments are also really nice. And treble. Treble is actually very, very perfect, very good balanced. They are not harsh, but they are really detailed with perfect attacks and decays, but absolutely not harsh, and but not sound muddy or moved backwards like sometimes happens when sound engineers try to create not fatiguing treble. So they Unique Melody really nailed their task here, and they indeed built a really good treble with absolutely realistic attacks, decays, and with good extension, but not sounding too sharp or too present. So what else I can say? There is all the necessary air, all the necessary decays of the instruments, absolutely great sense of realism with complex instruments, so everything is put here. And the fun thing is that they are not super super demanding in terms of the material. Of course, if you have some not super good recorded material, you will definitely hear all the that flaws, all the issues, all the mistakes and so on, but actually it still be pretty pleasant and pretty listenable, especially if you select copper version of cable. So this is not sharp sounding IEMs, which will bring forward all the details, so it's not for some probably it's not a perfect model for some professional usage for monitoring. It is definitely a model created for those who'd like to listen to the music with the best possible quality. So not out, probably maybe not some professional model for well, actually I've said that before, so I won't repeat it once again. But they really require a good source which will perfectly control them all over the spectrum, and they will benefit, to at least to my taste, from Astell & Kern signature sound. So AK320 or SP1000, it is a perfect companion for them. Also, they pretty nice with Lotopav Gold, but actually Lotopav Gold is a bit more aggressive and a bit more forward and a bit more emotional dub, which will probably sometimes over energetic for them. Actually, I prefer Astell & Kern's representation more. And another great option, if you want to save, it's Ibasso DX200 with Amp4. I think M4 is best option here. You will have to use an adapter, but anyway, it's best sounding option for these IEMs. Probably some less expensive models can be nice too, but they won't show the full potential of these IEMs. So, to summarize this part, really great organic sounding model for those who'd like to listen wide selection of genre, absolutely no compromises. Of course, this review won't be complete without some comparisons. I've got a few models in this price, well, not in this, but in upper price range, which can be compared with Unique Melody, but one model I will probably skip, it's Campfire Audio Vega, because Vega is pretty colored with their own unique sound, so they not Vega sounds like nothing else, so there is not much sense in comparisons. But another Campfire Audio model, it's Andromeda. It's probably the most affordable top of the line IEM. It's like a ticket to the world of this absolutely high-end audiophilia that you can buy for about $1,000, few, maybe just a bit more. So, of course, this model costs Unique Melody Mazin V3 costs three times more. Sorry, not three, just two times more. A bit more than two times more, and they offering more organic representation with much more weighty mids, with and this weight on the mids gives this sense of realism. Actually, it's one of the biggest, probably not an issues, but maybe an issue for the Andromeda. It's a bit lacking weight on the mids. They sound more like balanced armature IEMs. But of course it's noticeable because here 8 balanced armatures are responsible for the mids, and here 5 balanced armatures total. Some of them responsible for treble and for bass. So actually here is more weight, more organic sound, and more polite treble. Actually not polite, but not less bright and less harsh and less demanding to the quality of recordings, but still sounds very natural and very extended, with very good extension. So more weight, more organic sound, more body, they go deeper and so on. But actually, if we consider two time difference in the price, it's pretty expectable. Another model that I'd like to compare, it's my Ambient Acoustic Slam 7 Customs. So, of course, it's not 100% honest to compare Universal and Custom version, because this version is tip dependent and so on. But let's make a comparison anyway. Of course, they cost also more than two times less, and also they using just 7 balanced armatures, so, but anyway, they are more weighty on the mids than Andromeda, for example, and they probably the closest model in terms of general representation if you select proper switches in sound tuning. So Unique Melody is faster, especially on the lower frequencies, have a better treble extension and more sense of realism, and on mids and on treble, so even more realistic sound, bigger imaginary stage in all the dimensions, and more organic representation. But of course, it doesn't sound doesn't mean that LAM 7 is bad, they just simpler because they are more affordable in terms of price. Actually, Ambient Acoustic works on the 16 driver model and even 24 driver model, so I suppose I will get them in the Universal shells and will do a comparison more honest in the future. And the closest in terms of price, it is probably every personal audio fan can guess what this model is. It is Noble Audio Kaiser & Core. It's flagship model by Noble Audio, and actually Noble Audio can do really great custom designs too. They are well known for that, but I've got only Universal version, and but they are also great, I'd say. So Kaiser offers a bit different sound representation. Kaiser, I like the tuning of Kaiser Encore because it's a more V-shaped signature, but with more accented lows and with a bit more highlighted treble aggression, upper mids and lower treble accent. So it offers more forward sound with a bit more aggression and with bit more accented lows. It's not as realistic as this one, but it's engaging, it's fun, it's for those who like added emotions, while this one is for perfect portraying what is put in the recording. So, to summarize, it's endgame model. It's super expensive, but Unique Melody indeed try to do their best to make them really correspond that price and offers as much sound, design, comfort and other stuff as possible. So if you're looking for some endgame top of the line model, I think it's one of the best options, at least of all that I've heard. Thank you for attention.